In this video, we're going to take a look at the magnifying app or magnifier on your iPhone. This is an app that makes things a little bit easier to read. Basically, think of it as a digital magnifying glass. What it basically does is you aim your camera at whatever you want to read, and what it'll do is it'll capture it, and then what you're able to do is enhance that. You can apply color filters, you can apply contrast. And the beauty of this is it doesn't add it to your photo library. It's a completely separate app. Now, if you find this video helpful, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's take a look at the Magnifier app on the iPhone. Let's go over to my iPhone. Let's first see how we can find or where this Magnifier app is. It's located in your app library by default, not on a home screen. So when I swipe over to the left and I keep swiping, eventually I'm going to get to my app library. And then when I swipe down, what I get is a list of all of my apps. From here, what I do is I go over here to M's. I tap on the M. And now you're going to see Magnifier. This is the Magnifier app. Now, before we take a look at how this all works, let's go and add this to the home screen. How can I do that? Well, basically, all we have to do is just long press on it. So I long press on it, and then you're going to see add to home screen. I tap on that, and what it's going to do is it's going to add it to my home screen. And now it is just another app. I can move it to a different home screen. I can move it to a different place on this home screen. All right, so that's where we can find it and how we can install it on our home screen. Now let's take a look at what this app is. I'm going to tap on it to open it up. And I'm looking at my magnifier. So right now, I'm going to go to the overhead screen here, and what you're going to see is I have a document for a Weber grill, and it's pretty small. And actually what it is it's two-sided here. So this is a perfect case for using the magnifier. I want to take a picture of this and magnify so I can easily read it. So I'm going to go back over to my phone here, and now we're looking at my iPhone with the magnifier. So now what I'm able to do is just kind of move this up here and get that document in the frame, so we can see it's in the frame here. And then if I want to capture it, all I have to do is just tap on capture, and when I do, it's going to capture that image or that document. Now from here, what I'm able to do is pinch to zoom in. So I just pinch, and we can see I can easily read that text. I zoom back out. I tap to get back to my controls, and now I'm looking at all my controls. I can also zoom in and out of with this little slider here. And then if I want to use the reader, basically what it did is it read this for me and transcribed the text. I can tap on reader here, and I'm able to read that text. I can actually copy this text and place it into a document. Now when we're done, I'm going to tap on X up here to close this. When we're done with the document, all I have to do is just tap on close, and it's ready for my next image here. So I could flip it around and basically do the same thing here. Maybe this is a menu and it's hard to see. Well, what you're able to do is capture it, and then you can zoom in. So that's the basics of the Magnifier app. But we do have more with it, of course. So I'm going to close this. If we look here, you're going to see that we have settings. What I'm able to do is add filters. I can add contrast. I can even add a flashlight, add light to it. Maybe you're in a low lit environment. What you're able to do is turn on the flashlight. So I tap on that, and you're going to see that up towards the top, these are my different controls that are on there. I'll talk about activity in a little bit, but these are my different controls here. And then I have my primary controls. Remember how we had that zoom? That's why that zoom is there. And then I can go and add secondary controls. So let's go ahead and add a couple of secondary controls. What I'm going to do is I'm going to add capture mode. This allows me to capture more than one page. And what I'm going to do is add filters. And I like to add contrast. We're going to add one more. Let's go ahead and add flashlight here as well. So now these are my secondary controls. So how does this all work? Well, let's go back. I'm going to tap on done here. And then you're going to see that I have more controls here. So now what I'm able to do when I take a picture of this is apply a filter. That's what this one is here. So let's go ahead and apply a filter. And now I can make it black and white, and it strips out the color there. I can go and add a red filter, yellow filter, blue filter. And if I want to remove any filters, I can do that as well. The nice thing is we can also do this after we capture our image. I tap on a little circle here to close the filters, and I can also adjust the contrast. And then I can turn on the light, my flashlight. So if you're in a low light environment, that will turn on the light. You can see it got a little bit brighter there. So now I capture it, tap on capture. And if I wanted to apply a filter, I can do that even on the image. I just tap on it, and now I can apply a filter. So we can use these different tools after we take our picture, after we capture the image. I'm going to close this, and now we're looking at my image here. So let's go ahead and tap on X. I'm going to show you how we can read multiple pages. So I have this side, and then I flip it over, and I have this side here. I want to capture both of them. Well, if we look here, I have this little control here. This allows me to take multiple pictures. So I tap on it. And now you're going to see I have single and multi. So let's go with multi, because it's multiple. And now I aim. What I do is I tap on capture to capture the first one. I flip it over. If we look here, you're going to see we have a little thumbnail of the first one. Now what I do is I tap on capture again. And when I do, we're going to have two images here. So I tap on that little thumbnail, and now I can see those two images. I'm just swiping back and forth. I'm just going back and forth on the screen to go back to those menus or to those displays or to those documents. Sorry about that. Generally, what I will do, I keep saying menus because this is what I use when I go to a restaurant. And if it's a large menu, what you're able to do is take multiple pictures. And then you can kind of zoom in to read it. And then when you're done, all you have to do is just tap on close, and it'll close that image. It's not going to save it to the Photos app. That's generally how I use it. That's why I keep saying menu. But basically, what we're able to do is just kind of swipe to go to the different documents, and then of course I can also apply different filters or contrasts or anything that I add for my controls. Again, when you're done, you just tap on close here, and what it'll do is it'll close that, and it's ready for your next image. Now note that only closes that image. I can go and add another image to my multiple documents here. So how do we actually close out of this session? Well, what I need to do is I need to tap on this little X here. And when I do that, now it's ready for a new session. And I go over here and I tell it if I want it to be single or multi. So what is this little activity here? Well, basically what the activity does is it allows us to save different settings. So let's say that I wanted to save this or these controls here for a setting. Maybe I want it for my office. So what I do is I tap on activities here and I save the current one, and I'm just going to call this office. When I tap on this and I choose office, what it's going to do is it's going to apply all those different settings. Let's go and create another one. We're going to call this one low light. So I'm going to go to the settings here and I'm going to remove filters. And I'm going to put flashlight towards the top. So I'm basically just moving these around here a little bit. And let's move capture mode towards the bottom. We'll go with brightness. We'll add brightness. So this is going to be my controls for low light. So now I just tap on done in the upper right-hand corner. You're going to see that I have different controls here. And when I go to activity, what I'm able to do is save this as a new activity. So let's go ahead and do that. And I'm going to call this one low light. And I can even go and add a different icon to it. Watch what happens to these controls here when I switch to a different activity. I'm going to go to my office.
A white keyboard on a wooden surface.
And now
surface.
We can see we have different controls here. Now I go back over to my low light.
A white keyboard on a wooden surface.
And now
surface.
We have different controls. My flashlight is over here on the left. And it'll even remember that you need to turn the flashlight on. If I go and tap on the flashlight to turn it on, and then I tap on activities here, and what I do is I update my low light. When I do that, it's going to remember to turn that flashlight on when I'm in that low light activity. I tap on activities. I go over here to office.
A white keyboard
the flashlight
on a wooden
is off.
Surface.
I tap on activities. I go to low
a
light.
A white keyboard
the flashlight
on a wooden
is on.
Surface.
So it'll remember
a white keyboard
even
on a
if
wooden
you have
surface.
Something on or off there. Now, there's one other thing that we can do with our Magnifier app, and that is detect. We can detect scenes. We can detect doors. We can have it read it to us. Let's see how that works. What I need to do is I need to turn that on. So I'm going to go to my settings here, and then we go over here to detect. I tap on detect, and then the first thing I have to do is I have to go and show it in the control panel. Tap on it. Now, I'm going to leave all of this on. It's going to read to me. It's going to have sounds. It's going to have haptic taps. But you can go and adjust these accordingly. I can have it detect languages. I'm just going to leave that there. And then we have our different detectors. So I can have it detect scenes, people, doors, furniture, text, and even point and speak. I tap on scenes. And you're going to see that. I can set if I want it to be labels and speech. I go to people. Do I want to measure how far or how tall they are in feet and meters? I go over here to doors. Again, the units is at feet or meters, as well as the sound pitch difference. So I can actually see how close I am to that. So now I have this turned on. Let's just go and aim it at a few different things to see what happens. So I'm going to tap on done. You're going to see that I have detect here. And we're just going to aim my camera around my office a little bit. So let's go ahead and detect.
Touch and hold a piece of paper with text and numbers on a wooden surface. A screen
and now we can see it says scenes on.
More options.
Touch and hold to detect more options. But we're just going to aim it around here. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go up and you can see it says a piece of paper with text
and
images
on a wooden surface.
A wooden surface,
a tablet computer on a wooden surface.
I'm going to aim it up to my camera
screen displaying a list of applications.
You're going to see it says
a computer
screen.
A camera on a tripod in front of a computer screen.
Past my computer screen.
An illustration of a camera on a screen.
It says
a camera on a tripod in front of a screen.
An illustration of a camera in front of a computer screen. So it's not 100%.
A screenshot of a video game with an image of a person
here.
Holding a camera.
It says it's a video
an
game.
Electronic device
I go
with a screen
remote.
And buttons on a wooden
it does
surface.
Say that it's a remote.
A remote control on a paper
to
with
turn
text
this off,
on it on
we just
a wooden
go to
surface.
Detect.
A computer screen display.
If I were to aim that at a door, it would have told me how close I was to that door. So that's how detect works. Another little trick with the Magnifier app. So that is the Magnifier app on the iPhone. With this Magnifier app, it basically makes it easier to read different items such as menus. That's primarily how I will use it. I don't want to take a photo of the menu and add it to my photo library, so I just use this Magnifier app. And then if there's a lot of color or if there's low light, I can turn on the light, I can filter it, I can make it black and white, I can increase the contrast. And then if you want to use it for detection, you can also do that. You set this up all through the settings when you're in the Magnifier app. And you find the Magnifier app in your app library, and then you can move it to your home screen. So that's how we work with the Magnifier app on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family. You can subscribe to my channel. You also may want to check out danstutorials.com. In addition to having more videos, I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple Genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member, not only do you get access to that AI assistant, access to my classes and webinars, but I also take out all of the ads on the videos. And you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information. And thanks for watching.